Welcome back, and today we're talking about ReZero episode 35. So like always, let's jump into it. Yet again, ReZero delivers a great episode. I absolutely love this episode. We got a lot more answers now. Again, last episode, we had the Witch of Envy show up, and she was just wrecking havoc. She destroyed all of the sanctuary almost. She consumed everybody in there. And in this episode, she just destroyed everything once again. She killed Garfield with ease. I mean, she's just OP. And then she consumed Subaru. Now, of course, when Subaru was in there, we see a lot of memories, a lot of distorted memories and stuff like that. And Subaru at the end had to kill himself. But that scene right there was a very powerful one because we got to see the witch face. We got to see her face. And to me, that was a copy and paste version of Emilia. Now, I don't know if it's exactly Emilia who the witch is, or maybe it's like Emilia has like a twin sister, and that's who the witch is. I don't know at this point. Maybe she's a clone. Who knows at this point? Because they were talking about clones and how the Witch of Greed, Echina, she's the one that created the sanctuary. She's the one that created all the clones of Ryuzu because she's trying to find like a loophole. She's trying to find like immortality. She's trying to get her soul and transfer it over to another body so she can keep living forever. Or maybe she's trying to, you know, get a body like Ryuzu to where she can put her soul that's trapped in the sanctuary and put it inside somebody so she can finally leave that whole prison that she has. That's my theory. It's crazy. I mean, this episode, of course, we got a lot of information, stuff that I really don't understand, right? I know that we're talking about how Subaru, at this point, he's also an apostle of the greed or the witch of greed. And I don't know exactly how he became an apostle, right? Was it because he just drank her bodily fluids? If that's the case, that's a little weird. But then of course we learned that Garfield himself is one of the Witches of Greed apostle. So again, I don't know how he became one. Maybe he has some type of connection with Echina. I don't know, but it's something that's definitely way beyond my understanding. I'm definitely gonna have to do some research, or maybe somebody could explain it in the comments, because I know there's some people that have read the novels and they know way more about this kind of stuff. But we are getting some answers, and that's the important part. We see that Subaru, once again, he is determined to pretty much just do whatever it takes to help Emilia out. And now they did something in this episode that we haven't gotten in a long, long time. We haven't seen Emilia and Subaru kind of have a like one-on-one with each other by themselves. And this episode, we finally got it. They were talking to each other. It's been a while since we see them do that. And it was a very touching scene. We see that once again, Subaru 100% wants to help Emilia. And even though he had that little inkling that, you know, there's something wrong with Emilia after seeing that face of the witch, he still, you know, doubled down that he's going to do whatever it takes help Emilia. I like that. I really do. Because some other characters I feel would have just started mistrusting Emilia right off the bat. But no, Subaru is 100% still going all in. All his bargaining chips are with Emilia. And of course, we got to talk about the ending, because I really love the ending. Something about the music. The music at the end of an episode, whenever it kicks off, it just gets me pumped up for some reason. I really love it. It definitely gets those emotions rolling. Because we see that Subaru is rushing out to warn everybody in the mansion that the one assassin is gonna come in. So he's trying to tell him, you need to get out. But of course, before that happens, boom, Garfield, of course, he knows everything that's going on, tries to stop him. And of course, I thought he was going to die once again, right? I thought that Subaru was a dead man. But no, he confronted Garfield, and he seemed very comfortable to the point where he, you know, Garfield's whole attitude change. And he did whisper something. I don't know what it was. I'm guessing it was telling Garfield that he's also an apostle from the Witch of Greed. I'm guessing that's what it was, because why else would, you know, Garfield kind of back off? Maybe he recognized that during the same team, maybe. But that also brings the question, right? If he can smell that there's like a witch factor with Subaru, wouldn't he be able to tell that's Echina's like witch factor or something like that? I mean, again, it's stuff that I really don't understand. The story in this anime is very, very complex. And while, you know, you can have the basic level of understanding of what's going on, if you just, you know, dig a little deeper into the story, there's a lot of lore to be found. And, you know, I do think that Subaru right now, he is definitely 100% taking a big, big mission because he's trying to save everybody. He's trying to save everybody in the mansion. He's trying to save everybody in the sanctuary. He's trying to help Emilia. He's trying to kill the great white bunny or whatever that monster is that the Witch of Gluttony created, the monster that, you know, is like just duplicates itself into like hundreds and hundreds of bunnies and just eat everything. I mean, that one monster that you have to one shot every single one or else it's not going to die. So yeah, I think this is like the biggest mission that Subaru has ever taken, and he is determined to actually complete it without like anybody dying. I don't think that's going to happen. There's going to be some type of casualties, right? I can't imagine how Subaru, no matter how many times he resets, he's going to save everybody. I'm pretty sure something big is going to happen, but I am really excited about the next episode. I'm glad that we have gotten a lot of answers. But of course, the last thing I definitely want to talk about is the last scene, the Beatrice scene. And of course, that scene, you know, we see that Subaru finally confronts Beatrice. We know that she has one of those books that can, you know, look into the future and stuff like that. And she was talking about the end, the ending of an end of the end, like the true ending, I'm guessing, right? We're talking about Inception within an ending. I don't know what she was meaning by that, but I'm guessing either, I mean, I don't even know. I don't even know what to guess anymore, because to me, it sounded like she was going to go away and she accepted that fact. Of course, we know that Beatrice is following whatever the book says. And if the book says that she has to die now or whatever, she's probably going to go along with it. She was talking about the end of a contract, a very long contract. I'm guessing that's with the other guy. I forgot his name right now, but yeah. I really want to know what's going to happen with Beatrice and Subaru, because last time they were talking, we found out just how Beatrice kind of feels with the humans and stuff like that, and how she just didn't actually create a relationship with Subaru. She was just following whatever the book said, and that's kind of messed up. I can't wait for the next episode. I am truly excited. Hopefully somebody can explain some of the stuff that I'm kind of confused about in the comments, or else I'm gonna have to go do some research. But yeah, overall, great episode. I cannot wait for the next one. But like always, let me know what you thought of this episode. Go ahead, leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you on the next episode.